Okay, so just like every the beginning of every first session, if everybody can grab the force die, that's the white die, and go ahead and roll it on your list there. Around the character sheet. Yeah, that's not good. So, Brian, what the. Oh my goodness.
Is it on the character sheet as a force
Nope,
die?
it's at the bottom left corner.
You just drop it in the chat?
Yep, just drop it in the chat. Well, it's a good thing you guys brought him along.
Where did we pick him up?
Yeah, no kidding, right?
Get with the program, would you?
I think that's where we spent our light force was to pick him up, which means that now he's got the dark force.
Right. So,
I still haven't rolled a light force one.
You still haven't? No, it's been dark the whole time, hasn't it? So, Brian, those are points that you can use to add bonuses or to change the tide. So, you can use light points. Those are the white chits down below the force die. And then I can use the black chits against you as the dark side. So, they move back and forth. So, if I use one, it goes to you. If you use one, it goes to me. And they move back and forth. So, that's what
So
those are.
everybody rolled dark side chits, and the only reason that we got two light forces is
Yes.
because of me.
That's exactly right.
Ah,
Yep.
okay.
And beginning of every game, you roll those to see where that's at. And then the other thing that we do is we do obligation. So what obligation is everybody has a certain obligation score that they have. And so if you look at your character sheet under the main tab, you see obligation, it says oath.
Oath. Looking obligations. I see obligations.
So
I
you,
see oath. Yes.
yep, if you click the little blue box, the darker blue box, that'll give you a description of what it is. Kip, how much obligation do you have right now? How many
15.
points? You have 15? That's what I thought. Okay, I just wanted to check to see.
I have 15.
You have 15 as well? How about you, Sly?
I have 20.
You have 20.
I
Okay.
have yet to get rid of any of mine, thank you very much.
Let me just move you up in the top of the list here.
The terms were not appropriate for me to borrow the money to pay off my other debt.
And nobody will let you borrow off the ship, right?
That's the terms I'm referring to.
Whoops.
Just
Now
weren't
I've.
interested in the user's the user's interest rates.
So,
So,
okay, I read this now, so.
So your obligation is somewhere along the line you have an oath to someone that you owe somebody something, and the way obligation works is it's sort of like Han Solo and the debts he owed, right? So it's always kind of looming over his head. So everybody has a certain amount of obligation, and you can take more or less obligations to get certain things. So, such as Sly Fuzzball took a bunch to get a bunch of money. So he owes a lot of big debt to the Hutts. The way it works, though, is every day, every time before the game or before the start of the game, we roll a D100 die to see if your obligation comes into effect. And so here's everybody's obligation. So if you roll under 55, obligation comes in effect and it puts additional strain on your character, or stress essentially. And it affects a certain character if whatever that number is that's rolled. So you have 1 to 5 because you only have 5 obligation, but everybody else has much higher. And so I think my math was right there. Who's up to roll, or do we have the new guy roll?
I
Me,
rolled
I
last
rolled.
time.
No, I rolled last time because we didn't trigger it.
I can
I
roll.
rolled the first time and we didn't trigger it.
I'll be happy to roll. I'm
No?
sure I rolled last
No,
time.
Greg, you don't get to roll. Ever. I'm okay with anyone doing it.
right, Posh
Okay,
did it.
Posh did it.
And you rolled mine, dang it.
That's 7, right? That's not 70.
That is 7. That's correct. Yep. And it is Kip's. So the way it works is on your character sheet, do you see your strain under the combat tab, Posh?
I'm not Posh. That's a Spice Girl. I'm Pash.
Sorry, Pash.
strain up under my character sheet. Okay, where is it? Up under main or
under combat tab?
Combat tab, silk strain. Got it.
Yep. So that's your normal threshold. So everything goes up in this thing. So you don't go down. And so when you guys take obligation, you take one less strain from you. So yours, it goes down one. So you change that to whatever it would be, 9 for you. And because Kip's obligation is the one that was triggered because you rolled a 7 and she's 6 to 20 on that table that you see there, she actually takes 2 strain, or she reduces her strain by 2.
Now what that's representing, Brian, is that one of her obligations should be somehow showing up in our session tonight.
Potentially, right.
And how do I know what my obligation is? I don't see an obligation yet, but I guess I will learn.
So it's on the main tab sheet, and I just randomly rolled one for your character since it's just a kind of a fill-in character. And so it says oath. So if you open that up, that's what your obligation would be. And you can write that. It's kind of like your background or your backstory.
Mine says magnitude. Okay, so obligation, details, magnitude.
Yep. And then you see
the description.
Right. The description is kind of what it would be.
Oh, so I have an oath to something.
Correct.
So that's my... Okay, let me think.
I got lots to pick from on Kips.
Look at all this stuff. What I'm recommending is that whoever is under the strain of the obligation, we stuff them in the trunk of the hover vehicle, and that way they never have to interact and worry about it.
There you go.
Except for Kip, we're gonna strap her into the front seat.
Gonna be a rough session, Kip.
I know.
Like with that exasperated voice, I know. All right, so you guys have landed on the planet of Savi. As you remember, you had done sort of a deal with the Black Sun and had completed the shuffle. You had received free docking bay fees here at the South Dock, or at the South End. I can't remember exactly the name of it. You also had received free power, so there's really no maintenance fees for you for your ship to be docked here. You guys have had time to have some time here and kind of do your normal things and whatnot.
Did we get the ship fixed?
I think the ship is fixed. It looks like everything is, the strain is 0, the wounds are 0 on the ship.
So how long have we been here?
We're going to say a week.
Would my wounds be healed if I spend time with the doctor?
Yep, they would be. Everybody's wounds are healed. This would also give you a chance to interact and to have Pash join your crew however you guys would like, or however Pash would like to find the crew, or however you guys want to go about that.
Well, I want to visit a bar.
Alrighty, sounds good.
Listen.
Pash is in a cantina right now. He doesn't know what these bar things are.
All right, sounds good. I'll get a cantina up here in just a second.
Listen, Sly, you know, there were a lot of Salonians that we dealt with on our little, like, micro jump experience.
That is true. I want a bar installed on the ship.
Yeah, we'll add that to the priorities.
This looks vaguely familiar.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
You know these cantinas. They find a design they like, and they put them up all over the galaxy.
It's a chain.
Is this McCantina? Is that what it is?
It is. It absolutely is. So, Yes, Brian, I haven't taken care of all the stuff that you sent me yet, so
Yeah, because there's cantinas
I
there.
know I haven't had enough time. I apologize. I've been crazy busy. So as you guys walk in, you do see that the bar is relatively busy. There's definitely a bartender behind the bar. There's several Rhodians that are sitting there at the bar, as well as some Twi'leks.
I think we asked last time, I can't remember. What is the situation on the planet with personal weapons?
No, I don't think you did ask on this planet. So you see that most of the people here do kind of have either like a blaster or a kind of a vibro knife or something like that. Now you don't see anybody carrying around like big, heavy artillery type weapons.
Oh, that's their problem, not mine.
But you do see that there is weapons do seem to be pretty comfortable here and whatnot.
Do see at least one guy carrying a blaster rifle.
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes.
You think we could maybe like pick up like a mission or something here? Like you get any bounties or whatever that would take us back, into my side of the universe so we can maybe, start working on finding that Rodian that I'm looking for?
I do have a couple of outstanding bounties, but I think I'm gonna put them on hold because both of them are crew members.
I think you're ratty.
So I do. I have had a contact from my manager. He says he's got a bounty for us, so I don't know where that is yet. So I'll give him a holler on. Subspace frequencies.
Alrighty, sounds good.
I'm gonna go in and find a place to sit.
Alrighty, gotcha.
Gotcha. I
I'll
like the
meet you at the
place.
bar when I'm done. The cantina, sorry.
All
That
right.
works.
I see this guy as I'm walking by. I kind of give him a indirect look, just look him over, and then walk on past.
All right.
Hey Sly, what you drinking?
Fuzzy navel.
Of course.
Now, what's Sly's race?
I'm a Salonian.
He's cat people.
No, I'm a weasel person.
So as you kind of sit down, you do see that the bar appears to be pretty busy. What I'll have you guys do is go ahead and let's see. I guess we'll do a perception check for Pash. So Pash, do you have the dice pool tracker up? You probably don't, do you?
The thing that said, yep, I got it now.
Okay, gotcha. So that'll show you everybody's dice pools as I set them up. So what I'll have you do is I'll have you go ahead and look at your skills and find the perception skill.
Yep,
And
got it.
there's a die that's there on the right. Go ahead and grab that and drop that into the box just below your chat box, the little blue box. Perfect. Excellent. And
Holy
then
crap, is he perceptive?
he's really good, isn't he? That's great. And then I'm going to have you go ahead and you're going to grab an easy difficulty, which is one purple die, and drag it in there. All right. And then so that's kind of how you build your dice pool. And then I add setback and boost die if you need to. And I'll have you go ahead and click the check mark in that box. Sorry, you're trying to get communications across, is that correct?
Yeah, I'm gonna contact, is it Tazzy?
Sure, absolutely. So you're gonna kind of contact Tazzy. All right. So I have you kind of going to hook up through the communications there. You're just kind of outside the bar, I take it?
I was going to be back at the ship and just meet him there after I had the contact.
Perfect. That sounds great. All right. So for Pash, so as you can see the dice roll there, so you have a success, which is one, right? And then you see the advantage. You have two symbols that are there. So if you click on the perception box, it kind of tells you what those symbols do in the description if you scroll down in it. So, Kip, you kind of come up to the bar. You see the bartender's there. He kind of comes over and he says, "Howdy, miss. What's up?"
"Well, sir, I would like to order a couple of drinks for my buddy and I."
"Sure, sure." He says, "I see the droid behind you."
"The what? What?"
"The droid behind you."
"Yeah, I do."
"Yeah, yeah. She takes all the orders for the drinks."
"Oh, really?"
"Yep."
"Well, then I will head over to my table then."
"Aye." And he kind of moves back and you hear him kind of talking to the Rodian. He's like, "Those furry things."
Do the Rodians, like, pay me any attention?
They just kind of look in your direction as he says that, and they sort of go back and kind of talk back and forth amongst themselves.
I take the long way around.
Alrighty. As you do, you see there's a Shadra that's sitting over there kind of by himself, drinking a frothy drink that's there. And you see there's a droid that's up on the stage that's trying to do a little bit of music playing. They got like four different instruments they're playing with multiple arms. You see there's a Wookiee that's sort of sitting at the table, sort of nursing a drink. He appears to be pretty sloshed as his kind of eyes are kind of going back and forth and whatnot.
Is he armed?
He is armed. You see that he has a bowcaster.
"What you sitting in this big seat for?" "Sly."
"Yeah, yeah."
"Why are you in this big booth?"
"Because I can fit. We can move if you want to."
"Nope. You expecting company?"
"You never know."
"So
wait, I'll sit there so I can see the bar."
All right, sounds good. So Pash, as you're kind of sitting there watching, you notice that there's this Bothian that's walked through. You've been at the bar kind of scoping things out, looking for a job for the last couple weeks. Unfortunately, your ship had an unfortunate accident, and your ship has been kind of destroyed. So you've been kind of watching the bar to see if anybody's coming in that seems to be from out of towners and whatnot. And you know that most of the people in this bar are pretty regulars. Matter of fact, the Wookiee pretty much gets drunk every night, and you have to help him get home or whatnot. And you see this Bothan kind of walk through the bar, sort of casing the joint. And you see her kind of go sit over on the edge, but she definitely looks like she's not from the area here.
And that would be Kip?
That would be Kip, yep.
Alright, I saunter on.
Alright.
I'm like, my name's Pot Pash. Damn it, I almost said Posh.
Yes.
You might as well just go with it, buddy.
Pash Kraken, that's how people know me. You're new to town. What are you guys doing here?
Hello, Pash. Posh or Pash?
Pash.
I didn't quite understand your accent.
It's Carillion.
Ah, okay. Haven't been to Carillion in a while. Nope, we're just visiting. Waiting for our captain to show up.
Your captain? Is that skinny Wookiee over there with you? And I'll point to him.
So you point over at Sly.
I just move my hand perceptibly closer towards the axe, which is leaning up right next to me.
Yeah, he's a mini Wookiee. We call him Fuzzy.
Well, it seemed like the one I needed to be talking with here, so, you know, I just happen to be one of the best pilots around, if you had no get my drift. Scoot back closer to her. Or him, whoever it is.
Sly?
And you know that I did fly for Teemo.
Who is Teemo?
Teemo the Hutt! You don't know who Teemo the Hutt is?
Is he here on the planet?
No. Teemo's not on this planet. Nope, but he's on a different planet. Yep.
No, Teemo's not on this planet. I had to kind of leave his employ because, we had a little problem with some pirates. And, they kind of messed up the freighter I was flying for him. So, I did work for him, but now I'm looking for work around wherever.
Huh. Well, that's interesting. Fuzzball here, he's our pilot.
Who?
The skinny Wookiee.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to laugh at you.
Tell him, Sly. Tell him how great you are.
Best pilot we've got.
Well, he's telling the truth. He is the best pilot that we've got.
Well, you know, that I'm looking the ship over with some folks that, you know, like a little secret little adventure, get some credits in my pocket. You know, and I'd be willing to fly for you for, you know, cut.
Well, you can cut you, that's for sure.
Well, our captain should be back soon. I don't know what he's got lined up, but yeah, we're all about the credits.
Are there any Hutts on this planet? Or any factions for the Hutts on this planet?
if you say that out loud.
I said it in a conversational tone at our table.
Well, you know who we just worked for, right? That's definitely not a Hutt.
I understand that. It's not like I'm a Carillion or something, you know?
Just then the droid comes over and she says, "What do you want? These tables aren't free."
Yeah, give us a fuzzy tauntaun, and what kind of cider do you have?
She says, cider? We've got the Oompa cider.
I'll try that one then.
Sure. And then she goes, "Oh, hi, Posh." And she sits down and kind of rubs her hands through your hair. She's like, "Good to see you."
"My name's not Posh, I told you it's Pash."
Sorry. She's like, "How you doing, sweetie? We gonna get together tonight?"
Is this a droid?
Yeah.
Very lifelike.
She goes, "Oh, I see. All right." And she looks to Kip and she goes, "He's a player."
I kind of got that idea.
Bring me the usual. So, you know, the special bantha piss.
I'll be right back. She kind of goes back to the bar.
I guess the skinny Wookiee's buying, right?
Hey, yeah, with your money. I bought it last time.
You did, didn't you?
You're damn skippy, I did.
Well, the captain can cover this one. So, Pash, you said you're from Corellia?
Yeah, I'm from Corellia. That's what I said, didn't it? You didn't understand me?
You have an accent. Fuzzball knows a lot about Corellia too, right?
I know that they have some okay pilots.
Is that all that's on Corellia?
It's lost on Russell, sorry.
What kind of accent do I have?
Wait, is Corellia an Outer Rim planet?
No. It's Core. So, as you guys are kind of talking, sorry, you were going to communicate with okay, gotcha. So, as you send the communication across, you kind of get the comms, and the comms coming up, and it goes, "Sorry, hey, where you been, my friend?"
Flying the jet streams.
Yeah. So, how's the bounties coming, huh? You about got that Salonian yet, or what?
That Salonian's proven a little wiry.
Hmm.
Well, I haven't been able to track him down yet.
I gotta be honest, our employers are getting a little hesitant. I think they've taken out a couple more bounties on it. Kind of one of the best. I have to get my cut.
Well, if I find him, you'll be the first to know.
I hope so. So you're looking for another job, huh?
Yep.
Well, where are you at? What region are you in?
Savvy.
Ah, Savvy. Hang on a second. You see him kind of working on something out opposite side. Oh, you were doing through a comlink. Sorry. So you hear kind of typing on the keyboard and whatnot. You go, Savvy. Savvy. Oh, Black Sun area, huh?
Yeah. It's kind of dark here, yeah.
Yeah. Interesting. Kind of way out from where I would expect you to be. Your mark's out there, you think?
There was a glimmer, but turned out to be a dead end.
Yeah, he's a wily little thing, isn't he? So, well, let's see, Savvy. Yes, I do. I have somebody that I want you to contact. His name is Kaya Gosler. Yeah, Kaya Gosler is the name. Looks like he's, this may be, it pays well. Oh, you want to deceive him? Yeah, that's probably a good idea, actually, so.
That was me, so I told him I'm from Corellia. I'm really from Aldir, whatever, Princess Leia's planet.
I gotcha, all right.
Okay. Alderaan.
All right, no worries. So he kind of looks and he says, yeah, I think I have a pretty good bounty for you. He says, looks like it's worth about 4,000 credits.
Well, I'll tell you, the last couple of weeks or months or so, this ship's taken quite a beating, so I'm going to need some quick credits to get her back into ship shape.
What'd you do to the ship?
Just ran afoul of some Imperials and other sorts.
then this is right up your alley. He says, you'll love this one. He's like, matter of fact, the mark is an Imperial. It's an Imperial Overseer. Her name is Bryn. Brynn. She's there on the planet. I guess she's been kind of working at the space control. And it sounds like the person that wants this bounty thinks that she's charging a little too much to let ships leave. I'll send you all the information for it.
On Savvy?
Yeah, believe it or not. So, it sounds like she's kind of playing both sides, so.
Do we know who the, who's asking for the hit?
He says,
bounty,
yeah.
Is it a dead or alive, or just a dead?
I don't know, you're gonna have to go ahead and talk with Kaya to find out. Looks like Kaya is a shopkeeper, runs sort of a warehouse in the area. It's in the Black District. I don't know where that is. Never been out to Savvy. Is that a pretty nice town, by the way? A pretty nice planet? Sounds like a hellhole.
It's like most of the planets out here in the Rim.
Yeah.
It's got its good spots and its bad ones, and This one's got some shady ones.
Gotcha. And well, hey. Anyways, I would hit Kai up, and you know, you gotta keep me in a post about that Salonian. If you can't get that job done, you're gonna have to pay me some credits. You know that, right?
Yep.
All right.
Did they pay in advance?
Well, I mean, I have to pay them to be able to, you know, get into their favor. This is a kind of a middleman, you know?
Yeah.
Well, anyways, don't take so long contacting me next time. It's been a couple months. I don't like that. Figured you were probably dead.
Yeah, I didn't like it either. Okay, well, we'll clear this one up quick.
All right, I hope so. See you later, buddy.
Yeah.
All right. And comms go blank.
I'll make my way over to the corner.
Before we continue on, since Brian did that deception role, how does that work when it's an opposed role, deception versus discipline?
Yep. So the person that's doing the role, so the person that's trying to deceive would actually be the person rolling. So it'd be his deception versus your discipline.
So would he take my discipline skill and add that as difficulty dice and stuff?
Yeah, we can do it right now, actually. So, Pash, go ahead and put in your, go ahead and put in your deception roll into the box again.
Damn it, I rolled a good roll.
You did, I know, but you can roll even better, to be honest with you.
Yeah, but I rolled better, too.
And then we'll have you go ahead and put in three difficulty die. Oh, wait, what's yours? Yeah, three difficulty die, because that's his ability die. And do you have any, Pash, do you have any abilities or talents that increase that? So what you do is look at your main screen, main tab, and look at the talent you have. And click that box.
I got quick strike.
Yep, so you don't. But sometimes you can take talents that'll give you boost die, which adds your ability, or remove setback die. Sly, do you have anything that would help with determining deception rolls?
No, I do not.
All right, gotcha. So that would be your roll, Pash. So you go ahead and click that. Nice. So what that means, Pash, is you were successful in deceiving them, right? But you took threat. And you got a special. Wow. That's much better than the roll you rolled before, by the way.
Okay. What's a threat mean?
So a threat is something that I determine. So essentially what that means is you succeed, but it's at a cost.
But everybody believes I'm trustworthy, so I don't have to make any future checks.
So,
well, if you look at the deception skill, the threat on there says per threat, you give away a portion of the lie, making target suspicious.
So what I'm going to do is I am going to make it. Let's see what we got here. So, yep. So you guys do feel that he's sly. You feel he's trustworthy. So Pash, you're going to take two strain for two of the threats. So each threat can give you a strain. So you're actually going to put two in your strain column under your current strain.
Where is it at?
It's combat tab.
Yep.
Okay. So my threshold's 9. So what do I do? I'll put two up under current.
Yep. Two under current. Yep. And if you reach 9, you go unconscious.
Oh, damn it. Does this ever reset or?
It does after a combat.
But I'm not in combat.
I know. And then the last threat I'm going to keep for myself. All right.
So, really, you're from Corellia?
Yeah.
What parts?
Northern Corellia.
Oh, yeah, that's my favorite part.
That's really good. So, yeah, back to where we were at, you know. Who's this captain we're waiting on?
Sorry?
Where's this captain we're waiting on?
Yeah, Captain Sorry.
But where is he at?
Oh, he's probably on the ship. He should be here soon.
Yeah, he's on the ship, damn it.
The ship's name, damn it? That's a cool name.
I so wish now we would have named it that.
So that never came up.
The droid hands
I walk in and...
All right.
I see that Kip's kind of trapped by a slick-looking fella.
All right.
And I tell Sly to move over. And I look over at the new guy and kind of hand my or stick my hand under my jacket near my hideout blaster and say, who's the new guy?
Hey, Captain.
Apparently he's for sale.
Yeah, I'm the best pilot in these parts.
And I look over and give Kip a sly look.
So I look at the new guy and I'm gonna say, look.
And who are you?
What's up, fella? And where are you from?
My name's Pash and I'm from Corellia.
The northern part.
Yeah, I don't recognize the accent at all, being as I'm from Corellia. I look to Kip and say, is that right?
Are you from the north?
Yes, sir. He's from the north of Corellia.
So, Pash, I'll have you do another deception roll
against
Saris.
Should I throw mine in there?
So, sorry, yours is discipline. No, he's going to do his. So he'll go off your discipline. So if you want to put it in there, you can see what he has to roll against. Okay. So, Pash, you're going to add 2 difficulty die. But you're going to have a setback die because Sari actually is from Corellia and knows Corellia really well. All right, now you're going to go, oh, and you know what? We'll throw in a dark side too. So what that means is the luck is against you now. So you're going to click the purple button, the purple plus in the box. That's going to upgrade one of the difficulty dies. So that's what happens with a dark side. So it's going to turn your purple to a red challenge die. Yep, there you go. Now you can roll it.
What if I want to use one of these other
things? You could use a force one, so you can use a light side point.
But that's for the whole group, right?
It's for everybody, but...
No, I don't want to do that.
Alrighty, fair enough. Wow.
Whoa, look at that! Bamsis!
Damn, he believes he's Corellian more than we do.
Right?
I guess I'll believe him for now.
Yeah, right?
It just doesn't sound right.
I look at him, I was like, are you sure you're from Corellia? And who are you? What's your name?
Sorry?
I said, what's your name?
Yep. And I sit down. So, we got us a bounty here, Sly, Kip, on the planet. We got to go talk to, Kaya Gosler, are we taking this new guy with us? Is that what's happening here, or have you guys decided something without me?
Well, he wants to. He's looking for work, and he said that he can fly pretty well.
I said, to be exact, I am the best pilot in these parts.
And I believe that as much as I believe about your North Corellia.
Well, ask the captain over there. He's very apologetic about things.
What else do you bring to the team? Because we won't have to fly right away.
Can you drive? Yeah. Because we have a problem with crashing.
We do not.
Yeah, I can drive. I can drive anything as long as I can get it cranked up, but I can do that too. Pretty good at fixing things also.
How well do you know the planet that we're on? And the city?
I've been here, not like a regular, but been through here a few times. Hey, excuse me. Let me get around here. Yeah, right here. And I kind of sneak a little low. You see me kind of easing down in my seat there?
His head's barely above the table.
You have a problem there, sir?
You see four humans come walking into the bar, and they're kind of scanning around at the time. And you see they kind of walk over to the bar, and you hear them talking to the Twi'lek that's sitting there, or the Twi'lek.
You also see Pash pulling his blaster and holding it up under the table. I look at Kip there, and I'm like, those guys are some of Teemo's guys. They may be here for me.
Oh, okay. I see how it is. So what you're saying is if we kind of help you out of this mess, you would drive for us while we're on planet, right? For free?
Yeah, I'll be like your taxi cab driver. Call me Uber Pash.
Uber Pash it is.
But I don't have a vehicle, but I'm really good with speeder rides.
Yeah, we've got a speeder. You stay there.
I crashed mine, though.
What? Wait.
Yeah, I'm driving.
Just then you see the droid kind of points and she says, I think he's over there at that table. And you see the two thugs kind of turn and look towards your table.
Get up.
I would like to casually push the two tables slightly farther apart so that there's a larger space in between them.
Alrighty, so you kind of push those tables. So Kip, you're getting up?
Yep, I just stand up, trying to block their view of Pash.
Okay, alright, sounds good.
Are the tables bolted to the ground?
Is it one of those kind of bars?
No, they're not. They're not bolted down to the floor.
Okay, good.
So,
I'm getting ready to flip the one in front of me.
Alright, sounds good. So Kip, I'm going to have you do what kind of check would you like to do to make it so that they can't see him?
I guess a skullduggery.
Okay, that sounds good.
I'm just trying to get in front of him to...
Yeah. Pash, I'll have you do a setup for a stealth for me, all right? And then, sorry, you're going to be potentially flipping the table is your thought.
Yep.
Okay, gotcha. So I'll just have you kind of there waiting, and it'd be an athletics to well, no, actually, it's not bolted down. You'll be able to flip it. And then how about for you, Sly? What are you up to?
I am drinking my drink.
Alrighty, sounds good. So I'll have you do a cool check just to make it look like, hey, I'm here and just chilling like a villain. And then for their roles, you guys, for the difficulty, it will be... three difficulty die for everybody. And I think...
Well, this should go well for me.
Sly, I'll have you roll first.
Okay.
Alright, so,
Not looking good at all.
It's giving me away, isn't it?
What's that again?
I said it's my thumping tail that's giving me away.
Yeah, you hear this thumping underneath the table, like doo, 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 and one of the thugs kind of turns and seems to almost focus towards that table immediately as he hears the thumping. Kip, I'll have you do your skullduggery for me. Alrighty. So, Kip, you're able to kind of get into position in between you and Pash's view from those two that are there. You will take one strain, however. And then, Pash, I'll have you make your roll, but you can add a boost die for Kip being able to kind of stand up in front of you. So, yep, there you go. Nice job. At you, holy smokes.
I'm a bush.
Jeez.
Fuck, he's part of the table.
Jeez, oh, Pete. So you are successful, and you are able to slide underneath that table so quickly. Kip and obviously everybody else, you see that this is not the first time he's hid behind a table. He's pretty good at this. And
yeah, it looks like he's got a nest down there.
Right. Yeah, right.
Nothing to see here.
You see that one of the thugs kind of walks over and kind of comes up along the edge towards Sari. You see the other one kind of goes up towards the other side of the bar, and then the other two are sort of standing at the doorway now. And he kind of comes over to you and he says, "Hey, you seen any human guys? Got a scruffy looking, got kind of black hair, goes by the name of Pash."
"Oh yeah, of course we have."
"Oh, you have?" And he immediately walks over to you.
"Yeah, he's like the greatest fighter pilot in all of Corellia, right?"
"Greatest fighter pilot?"
"Well, that's what he was telling all the little ladies in here the other night."
"Well, I gotta tell you, he crashed three of Teemo's ships and he owes them about 15,000 credits."
"Oh, no, that can't be the same Pash."
Yeah, it is. It's gotta be, don't you think?"
Could be.
"And he..."
"Well, he was in here a little earlier. I think he just slipped out right before you got here."
"Really? Huh. That's interesting." And then...
"Why is that?"
He looks at me and he says, "You look familiar."
"I do?"
"Yeah.
You know, we Bothans, we all look alike."
"Yeah, you do." And just then he kind of looks over and he sees Sly. There's like drink dripping down from underneath his nose over his mouth. And he's like, "You all right there, son?"
"Sure am, Dad. Just got something in my throat."
"All right, just checking." And he goes back and he says, "Yeah, I've seen you before."
I grabbed Sly's tail, stop it from thumping so the guy doesn't look under the table.
"Sounds good."
"When he grabs my tail, I'm going to take a hold of my axe. It's leaning up on the seat beside me, so..."
Alrighty. As he looks at you and he says, to Kip, he says, "Have you ever been to, like, oh, I've seen you before."
"Yeah, why don't you come over here to this table with me and we can talk about it."
He's like, "Okay." And so he kind of goes, "Which table do you want him to go to?"
As they turn to start to walk away, I'm going to say, very kind of quietly, "Give him a good price."
So he kind of walks over. And...
I stop and turn around and said, "You disgusting furball."
He looks back and he says, "Yeah, disgusting furball. That was rude." He says, "Go ahead, have a seat. I'll sit here." And he sits down.
"Thank you."
He's like, "Have you ever been to Lord Mantell?"
"Oh, I don't think so. Why, have you been to Lord Mantell?"
"Oh, but something about you, Lord Mantell comes to mind."
"Oh, I was there years ago. Oh, we were going through on a freighter and we stopped by there and yeah, it was years ago."
He, he's like, you can see him kind of going through his mind. He's thinking, "What is your deception? Why don't you go ahead and add 3 difficulty die?"
"3!
Yep, that's a skullduggery. Alright.
"I've got all these things to reduce, and you're not putting any black dice in there."
Well, I'm happy to if you want me to. Oh, nice! So, how would you like to use your special for your deception? Forgot to go ahead. Continue. I'm sorry.
"Well, he's just going to believe anything else that I say without having to like do a pose check."
"All right, sounds good." So he's like, "Huh," and you see he kind of opens up, he has like a small little data pad. He opens it up and you see him kind of paging through, and as he does, you see that he has what looks like a bounty from the Des Moines Engineering Corporation, and he's scrolling down and you see names of people that were in the investigative branch, and then you see him scroll and he continues to scroll and he stops at Kasumi's picture and he looks at it. He's like, huh.
Oh, I know her.
You know her? And he looks down.
I do.
Really? Where is she?
Oh, wow. She's trouble. You know that, right?
I do know that.
And you see, I heard she was headed to the inner systems.
Inner systems? And you saw he was going down the alphabetical list backwards, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, or forwards, I mean. So he's at Kasumi, so you know who's next.
Yep.
And he's like, he's looking at it, he's like, well, what inner system? He's like, you're not going to cut in on this bounty, are you?
No, we've got other business. We're just freighters, man. Yeah, I heard she was going to Corellia.
Corellia? Huh.
Yeah, something about, you know, getting some kind of mechanics job or something there.
I see the other. Go ahead.
No, she's a mechanic, is what I heard. And yeah, she got some, like, big job working at one of the shipyards down there.
I see. And, see, the other guards are kind of moving around and whatnot. One slides in next to him, and he looks over, and he's like, are we down here or what? I don't see him in the bar. He's like, yeah, I was just going down this list. They know where this chick is. And he kind of shows the data pad over to the other one, and, he's like, oh, okay, all right. And
well, Greg, if I wanted to not hear the conversation that just went on in the booth beside us, what would I have to roll to see if I did or did not hear it?
You don't want to hear it?
Well, I want to know if I did or did not.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So that would be a perception is what I would use for that?
Because these places have a lot of music and stuff going on, right?
They do. So, Kip, you weren't talking at any quiet level or anything, were you?
Nope, I've got nothing hype.
Yep, so it's going to be an easy check. So it'd be one difficulty die, and then it's going to be a setback die for the music.
Is that it?
Yep.
I'm doing the same thing.
Okay, yep, so it'll be the same for you.
So about that time, I'm going to look over at Sari and say, I sure hope Megan's getting those systems fixed on our ship.
Megan or Kasumi?
Oh, sorry, Kasumi, yes.
Oh, my gosh. All right, sounds good. All right, so you say that. Pash, you're underneath the table just about, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so you see the thugs are kind of walking around. They don't really see you at all. You're continuing to kind of try to hide down there.
I am.
All right, I gotcha. So, yeah, you're definitely hidden underneath there. And as you say that, I'll have them roll. So, Kip, you hear that. You don't have to worry about not being able to hear that. Actually, we'll have you do a perception with easy and a difficulty die, actually. I'll have you do that. All right, go ahead and roll, Kip.
Just easy?
Yep, just easy. You cancel out the difficulty die, don't you? Oh, never mind. You don't hear it. So as you're sitting there talking to him, you see the guy, he immediately stops, and he looks back down at the pad, and he looks at his buddy. He's like, hey, this guy's behind us. Just said this one's name. And all of a sudden you see a guy across the table, Kip, signals to his other buddies. He's like waving them over, and you see the other buddy starts walking in his direction. And you hear them kind of, they've completely ignoring you now, Kip, and they're like, hey, that other table, they're talking about this bounty here. Like, let's go over there. And you see they immediately ignore you, Kip, and they come over.
Can I bump into that guy and try to get his data pad when he gets up?
Absolutely, Ken. So, Skullduggery, I believe it is. Correct?
Yes.
All right, and his perception, I believe, is that. So it's a challenge die in there? And he is distracted, so you get a boost die. Actually, a boost, not a setback.
She just wants to use her skill to remove that.
Yeah, I just wanted it so I could remove it.
I know. Yep, go ahead. And then, Pash, you see they... All right, Kip, so you take another strain. How would you like to use your special?
Well, it says I can identify an additional potential target. Can I pick his weapon off of him, too?
Sure. So you take, he has a holdout blaster, so you take that?
That sounds good.
Alrighty. So immediately you see these three kind of come over, and they look at you, Sly. Pash, I'll have you go ahead and make another stealth check for me.
Well, no.
I know. And this will be a, it'll be against, I grabbed the right one. Oh, maybe I gave you the wrong perception earlier. I'm sorry. I think I did negotiation. I'm sorry about that. It'll be 3 difficulty die.
Wow. See, I got 4 advantages though.
You do. Yep. So
last time.
Yep. So 3 difficulty die. And then, you're going to add a boost die because they're not really paying attention to you. You won't smoke. Sorry, you see the three of these coming towards the table here, as well as you, Sly. Go ahead, Pash, you can roll. All right.
I slide my hand into my jacket to my holdout blaster as I see them get up and start coming over.
Okay, all right, sounds good.
So, well, I had my blaster out a long time ago.
Yep, so it's in your hand. You're still hiding really, really well underneath there. With your advantage, you can take away a strain if you want to, so you can reduce one of your strain. Or you could give it a boost die to somebody else in the future for one of their future roles or the next person to go. It's up to you. It's one or the other.
I'll take my strain.
Alrighty, gotcha. So, Kip, you see the three of them are now kind of surrounding that table. What would you like to do?
Well, I have worked with my buddies more or long enough to know that it doesn't matter what I say or do, it's going to be bad.
All right, fair enough.
So I'm coming over here to try to get into a position.
All right, so you kind of work your way over there.
Yep, so, and I'll try to, I already have his holdout pistol, so I will just kind of set up over there.
All right, sounds good. Sly, Heek walks over to you and he says, "Hey, I heard you say something about a Kasumi. Where's she at?"
"Well, I'm sure they're all over the place."
"No, no, no. I heard you say her name, and that's not a race." You see the other one walks over and he's like, looks at Sari up and down and he's like, "Hey.
Are you implying
that I don't know what to say to him, so I just sneer."
"Are you implying in all the universe that there's only one person named Kasumi?"
He's like, yeah.
"I'm just gonna snort. I actually did snort. I'm just gonna snort and pick up my drink and start taking another drink."
And all of a sudden he kind of pushes your shoulder a little bit. He's like, "Hey, I'm talking to you."
In one fluid motion, when he pushes on me,
yeah,
I would like to stand up and grab my axe and hit him with my tail.
Alrighty, sounds good.
Since he hit me first.
Alright, sounds great.
At least that's going on the official police report that way.
Sounds good. Alright, so Teemo, the first Teemo does not have a weapon. Or does not have his holdout blaster anyway. Alright. So go ahead. That's going to be the guy that's there. So it's going to be Teemo Thug. So
melee is 2 difficulty, right?
Correct. Well, yeah, you have to. Yeah, you're pretty much engaged. So
did I get him by surprise?
Yeah. Yeah, he wasn't expecting it.
Okay.
All right. So that's a hit.
Which one is this?
So it's the only one that's on the board there, and it's Teemo Thug Zero, just regular Thug. Sorry, I gotta make him smaller. Alright. So, I guess we need
Don't to... touch me.
Alright. So, we'll do initiative rolls. So, all of you, I assume, were expecting there was going to be a fight, so you all get cool initiative. So, Brian, on your character sheet, where it says initiative, there's a cool die. Yep, just drag that into your combat tracker.
Alright. Cool die.
I am never prepared, Greg. We've talked about this.
Sorry, you're going to put it in the box. So there's it says initiative cool right next to your characteristics, just under your portrait.
Yep, I see that.
Yep, go ahead and drag that into your dice pool box.
Okay, and I got quick strike too. Is that something I can use?
You will be able to use it. So it'll be after the initiative. So go ahead and click the roll for the initiative. There's no difficulty to it.
I thought I was reading something that I could jump initiative up. But that's okay.
Yep, no, you're absolutely right. So the way that works now is if you click on the blaster symbol on the top right, it's called the initiative tracker. You got it there?
I've got it someplace.
You'll get it. So in the top right, just above the two
dice. Yeah, I see it up there.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Where did I put it? I think I already got it open.
Okay.
If you clicked it again, it probably closed it.
I don't see it. I see the combat tracker.
Okay, you see the combat tracker? That's what it is. So what you want to do is you're going to want to grab the bottom of the box and make it bigger because it's probably not big enough.
So it's not a part of the combat tracker.
It is.
Oh, it is?
Yep, it is.
Okay, I see. Initiative actors. Got it.
All right, cool. So on the top part, that's the kind of the initiative order. And the bottom part is your guys' characteristics and everybody that's in the battle. All right?
All right.
So the way combat works is you all share your initiative, so you guys decide who goes in what slot, essentially. So as you can see, the top slot is a 6.01. I'm not sure whose that is, but anyways. So you guys decide who goes first, and then whoever that is, you click your check mark.
Just out of curiosity, what does his talent do for him?
Yeah, so it's quick strike, so we'd have to look at it to see. I think it gives him a boost die.
Yeah, it gives me, the character adds blank per rank of quick strike. I don't know what the blank is.
Yep.
If combat checks made against any target that has not yet acted in an encounter.
So that's a boost die, so that gives you an extra blue die when you do your attack, and you only have one rank, so it gives you one boost die.
Well, I don't mind going first, or if someone else wants to, that's fine too.
I think the Salonian should go first.
Yeah, what do you guys go first?
Alright, in that case,
I have plans.
I am grabbing my axe with both hands and swinging above the table just in front of Sari and coming around to hit the guy that's right next to me.
Alright.
And see if I can wedge the guy up against the edge of the wall with the axe blade.
Gotcha. And you're already engaged with him, I think, correct?
Correct.
Okay, gotcha. Sounds good.
Are you spending any dice, Greg?
Nope, I'm not.
Alright, neither am I.
Okay.
Oh wait, I gotta do this first. I keep forgetting. How do I put me in the first slot?
There's a check mark in the lower part of the initiative actors next to your name. Just click that check mark on the left side of your portrait. Oh, never mind. Now there is.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome. My bad. Brian, I'm going to share a sheet with you. It's a little busy, but it'll help you as we go by, okay?
Oh, I didn't get enough for a crit. That sucks.
Yeah, but you did hit, so as you look at his thing, he was successful. So you see it gave two successes, so every additional success adds to the damage.
Sorry, can you take that, the mouse stopped, it dropped the damage on Kip. I did not intentionally do that.
Please don't hurt me.
That's awesome. So you can re-drag it onto the team of the thug. Alrighty. So you hit him, and as you do, you see, obviously, he's pretty bloody. You kind of hit him with the tail. It kind of knocked him back against the wall, and now he's got, like, blood across his face and everything. And you were hoping to pin him against the wall?
Yeah, I was hoping to drive the axe in far enough to just, you know, kind of put the axe into the wall a little bit as well, but I don't think I did.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, nope.
Is it an action to go defensive?
Yes. No, it's not. It's a maneuver. You mean to be in a guarded stance?
Yes.
Yeah, so yeah. It's a maneuver.
Because I have not done a maneuver yet, correct? And pushing a table would be a maneuver, or an action, correct?
Correct.
Alright, then...
Well, moving a table would be interact with the environment. That would be a new maneuver as well.
Alright, because I'd like to push this table... if I can, as a maneuver, push the table out and kind of push the back guy down, forcing him to try and take a step back down the steps and maybe stumble.
Oh, I see what you're doing. So you're trying to push the table this way?
Yes.
Yeah, you can push it that way.
All right, so that's what I'll do, and maybe I'll get lucky, and it'll make the guy back up and not realizing the steps there and maybe stumble a little bit.
Okay, gotcha. And then, so that's one maneuver. Did you want to do a guarded to take two additional strain for a second maneuver?
Just to confirm, the guarded is versus people shooting at me as well?
Let me double check, because it's been a few weeks since we've done actual melee combat. If anybody knows, please feel free to speak up.
Yeah, normally all we do is crash vehicles and Kip.
So guarded stance gives a plus one to melee defense.
Yes, I will go into a guarded defense to take two strain to do that.
Okay, alrighty, gotcha. So Brian, just so you know, on there you can do one maneuver and one action. You can replace an action with a maneuver to two maneuvers. So what he did is he did an action and a maneuver, and then you can spend two additional strain to do an additional maneuver. So that's kind of why he could do what he did. It'll come as time goes by.
And I can use that advantage to give a boost to the next actor, correct?
Correct.
That's what we will do.
All right, sounds good. All right, who wants to go next?
Well, I'll give it a try.
Go for it.
All right. So Timo Thug, Naught or Zero or whatever, he is wounded. He's pinned up against the wall with Kip's axe in him. Or not Kip's, I'm sorry. Not Sari's either. I'm sorry. Sly's. So you can shoot anybody that you want.
No apologies necessary.
Well, you know what? I'm going to assume that I was prone up under the table, so...
Yeah,
I am going to. My maneuver is going to be aim.
Okay, sounds good.
And I am going to shoot the Timo Thug one and try to kneecap him and then, you know, shoot him in the head.
All right, sounds good. So you're going to do a. So on your combat tab, you see your weapon.
Yes.
You're going to grab that die, put it in your box.
Got it.
So he is in short range. So short range, if you look at the list that I gave you. It's a one difficulty. Do you see that in the middle of the veteran cheat
sheet? Yes.
Yep. So you're going to do an easy difficulty. Right. And then you're doing an aim, so that gives you a boost die.
Okay.
There you go. That's it.
No, he also gets the boost for his quick draw thing, doesn't he?
That's right.
And the boost that I gave the next character.
You get three boosts. He's absolutely correct.
All right. Now that I'm all stacked up to my positives, I'm probably going to blow this.
I don't think so. I think you're going to kill him.
We only have one player that is able to make that many dice rolls and not get a success. Holy crap. That's a serious kneecap, man.
All right. So you did 14 damage. So what you do is you grab the word 14 in the chat box, click and hold it, and drag it onto either the token or onto the combat tracker, either way. All right. So you immediately knock him out with your shot. Now, you've got a triumph marker there, so you can use that as a critical hit. He's already going to take one critical because of him being knocked down. But you can use it as a second critical if you want.
So what is he incapacitated now?
No. Or? So he is incapacitated, but he's not dead. So when you reach your threshold of your wounds, you take a critical hit die. So you're going to grab. See where it says personal critical, the brown symbol that's underneath the challenge die.
Yes.
You're going to grab that and drag that onto Thug One. So that gives him the winded critical. So that's this. So even though he's incapacitated, it also he can't voluntarily suffer strain, which isn't a big deal. But the next thing is, if you want to do an additional critical to him, every critical you get, it adds 10 to the roll. And the higher the number, the worse the critical is. If you get 150, you're dead. So just for this, we'll do that. So I'll have you do another, put 10 in the modifier box. Actually, don't do that. I forgot. Never mind. Put a zero in the modifier box.
Okay.
And then just drop the personal critical back again on the Thug One. It'll automatically add the 10 for the one he has. There you go. So you rolled 102 that time. So now he's maimed, which means essentially you shot his leg off with that blaster, and he's now missing his leg.
Holy crap, it comes like flying over here next to me.
Yeah, it does. It goes flying by your head.
All right, and then what can I do with the special? Is that what I use my special for?
That would be a critical. Yeah, exactly. But there's other things you could do for that, but we just did that because I figured that was the best thing for this, if you're all right with that. All right? So he is down, out, missing a leg, bleeding out.
Now, his advantage can also be to remove one of his own strain or to give a boost to the next person acting for us.
That's exactly right. So you see on that sheet I gave you, Brian, it does have that advantage symbol there, and that's kind of the top left of that sheet, and it'll tell you what you can do. And those are just suggestions. Yep.
All right, so I kneecapped that guy, and he's on the floor bleeding out. So, he's bleeding. And that's the end of my turn, so I'll pass.
Yep.
Wait, Greg, I'm sorry. My vibro axe, does it automatically ignore 2 points of soak when I use it?
It depends on the description.
Well, it's got pierce too, so it ignores two, but I don't know if it actually ignored two of his soak or not.
It doesn't. I fixed it, so I added two to his death, or to his thing. So, Brian, you do have an advantage, so you can either recover a strain or you can give that as a boost die to the next person that moves in your party.
I will give it to the next a boost die to the next person in my party.
Perfect. Sounds good. All right. And then when you're done, click the down arrow. All right. So, I'm going to have... Did I forget to put Thug 3 on? I did. So... Thug 3 immediately reaches over, and as an action, he flips the light switch, and the entire place goes dark.
Where the hell's Thug 3?
He's over by the door. it becomes very dim light, so it's going to be at a disadvantage for you all. And you see that he moves, uses his second action, and dives over the bar. All right, next player.
I'll go, I guess.
All righty, sorry.
So I'll pull my my blaster out and shoot the guy that Sly's got pinned.
Okay, sounds good.
So is that a two difficulty now or one still?
So it's a one plus a, because you're shooting into someone who's engaged, so it's going to be an additional for your ranged. Are you doing your ranged light or ranged heavy?
Ranged light.
Okay, so it's one additional difficulty die.
That's it?
Yep. I'm not missing anything else, am I, Sly? I think that's it. Or anybody else that knows. I think that's it. Yep, go ahead. You can roll it.
Is there anything...
Shoot, yeah, go ahead.
I was wondering if there's a setback for the low light.
For the low light, you're right. Here's the setback die. Sorry, you missed the shot, but you get one advantage.
Hey, he didn't use his
boost die. I didn't use my boost die.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Use your boost die then. Just roll a boost die. All right, you have three advantage.
Yeah. I'm going to have to take a look.
You can't use your crit, unfortunately, because you didn't hit.
Yeah.
Thank you for the low light. I remembered right after he rolled. No, you don't stay in the order the same time. So the initiative stays the same, but you guys can pick whoever goes each time.
Okay.
I'm going to give an advantage to Kip.
Okay, all right, sounds good. And so that'll be two, it'd be one, so you have two advantage left over. But she's the next one to go, so I assume that's what you do.
No, it's two to name a person, right?
It is, but she's the only one left in the combat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she's the only one left, so if you wanted to, you could just do it as the next one.
Can I hang on to him?
You can, I think you have to use him.
Okay, well, that's it. I can't do nothing else.
So. You could do a free extra maneuver, so if you want to do that, you could use it as an extra maneuver. Or you could
get... Okay, I'm going to flip the table and get behind it.
All right, sounds good. So the table that slid out, I assume?
Nope, the one that's right beside me there.
Okay, all right, gotcha.
Damn it!
So you flip the table that's there. All right, sounds good. So the table's now flipped that way. Okay, all right, sounds good.
I don't have a...
I'm listening.
No, I flipped it.
All right, gotcha. All right, so Thug 1's bleeding out, so Thug 2 will go next. Thug 2 immediately runs over to here for one of his maneuvers. He takes two strain to aim at Sorry.
Have I got any cover for being behind the table?
So I think you have to actually take cover to be behind the table.
Okay.
Yep. It is low light, so he's going to take that. And it's a short range, so it's one difficulty die, I believe. And why not? I'm going to use the dark side chit.
How come I had two?
Because you shot into melee.
Oh, that's right.
And engaged, yep. And so he's going to take a shot. He fails. Wow, so the shot goes wide. And you hear him kind of curse as that happens.
Greg, can I be fair to you and suck for us?
Sure.
You spent that dark side point and increased the difficulty instead of his ability.
Did I? Okay, gotcha. That's all right. Next time I'll fix it. No worries.
All right. I actually have some goggles.
Oh, okay.
I can't drag it into the thing, but anyway, I have them. So would that take a maneuver just to like flip them down?
Yep, it would.
All right, so I can see in the dark.
All right, sounds good.
So the Wookiee standing right next to me, or sitting right next to me,
uh-huh.
I tell him, they've come for you. They're coming for you. You better help us.
All right.
And I try to convince him to join the fight.
Okay. All right. Gotcha. So you're going to use one of your skills?
Probably deception.
All right. It sounds good. And so it is going to be an easy. Yep. And with the combat that's going on, yeah, that'll be fine. We'll do that.
Well, if there was a setback, I would like get rid of it with my
convincing demeanor. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I was gonna say he's drunk, so probably would be a setback to that, but you can get rid of that. All right, and so he kind of pushes back the table, sort of staggers back a little bit, and he kind of gives out one of those Wookiee cries.
And I will spend two strain to get over here behind the table.
All right, sounds good. So two additional strain to get behind the table. So you're going to be taking cover?
Yeah.
Excuse me, sorry. Okay, all right, gotcha. So the Wookiee stands up.
Can I use one of that advantage to, like, get rid of one of my strain?
Yep, you sure can.
All right, so I'm at three.
All righty.
Nothing like the players to complicate your life by adding an NPC into the group on our side, right?
It's all good. I don't mind.
Nice job, by the way, there, Kip.
I don't know how to make him a PC, though, but that's okay. So, there's probably a way, I just don't know how. Okay, I'll figure it out in a minute. So for this, this will be the one that's bleeding out, or is on the ground. And the next one is the one that's pinned up against the wall. I can't tell you how many screens I have open, it's crazy. So he's gonna, I guess, punch at the Salonian because he doesn't have a blaster, so.
My melee defense is 2 currently.
Okay. And it's 2 difficulty die, if I remember correctly. And he gets a setback because it's dark. Wow, he still hit you. He probably won't do any damage, but yep. And he takes. So as he does that, he throws a quick punch, and as he does, you see it's like the arm that you hit, and blood kind of spurts out, and he sort of collapses down to the ground.
So did he just knock himself out?
He did. So he collapses. So the ones that are upside down are the ones that are knocked out. And it's top of the initiative order.
Do one of you guys want to shoot first?
Sure. Neither one of those guys are undercover though, right?
No, neither of them are undercover.
Okay, I'm going to take a shot at the guy by the table.
Okay.
Duck 2.
Alright, sounds good. So it'll be easy difficulty and 1 setback die because of the light.
Nice.
Wow. Impressive.
So that's the crit, right?
Yep, that is the crit.
So I dropped a little ball on him?
Yep, you do. And his damage, don't forget to drag your damage on him too. Alrighty, so he took a minor nick, which is right there if you want to click on it. So he suffers one strain, and he's a rival, so that actually just gives him damage.
Is that the one I shot? No, that's number three, isn't it?
That's number three, so that's the one that's by the table in the middle of the... that's the one behind the bar, right? That's the one you were shooting at? Well, that's the one you were shooting at now.
Yeah, right. I meant to shoot at Doug, too, but...
You want to shoot Thug too?
Yeah, but all that's okay.
No, it's okay. We'll fix it.
You just swap places with him?
Yeah. So there's the damage for it, and then I'll put the minor nick on him. And he took, what did I say, one wound? All right, so he's pretty bad shape.
And then as my maneuver, I'm just going to hide behind the table.
All right, sounds good. And then you'll take two strain for your threat.
Okay.
Oh, you need to click your little check mark thingy to be sure you're taking that turn.
Oh, yeah. All right, who wants to be the next player to go?
I will if that's okay, unless somebody else would like to go first.
Sounds like you, man.
I'm sorry, what was that, Brian?
That sounds like you should do it.
Okay, so my question to you, Greg, is this. Is it close range from me to the bar? Is that still close range?
Yeah, everything in this bar is short range, yep.
Okay, so first maneuver, I want to go over here and put a... foot on the stool between these two patrons, jumping over the bar close to the guy.
Okay.
And doesn't get me within melee range, though, does it?
No, you have to use two strain to get within engage. So in order to move into that extra right next to him to do anything against him, you have to be an engaged. So, yep.
Alright, I will take the two strain to move into engaged with him.
Alrighty.
And then I will swing my axe.
Okay, sounds good.
And I'm going to say, you can take this message back to Teemo.
Alright.
And I want to use a light side point.
Alright, sounds good. And you can see in the dark, so you do not take a disadvantage. Or a setback die.
I think that's it.
Yep, that's it. Oh, snap.
Damn it, I keep missing the critical.
So, now, you got a critical.
I did?
You got a special triumph.
Oh, that works. Okay, yeah.
So remember to add in your plus, what is it, 30?
Okay, but for the damage dragging it over, the axe ignores 2 points of soak, so how do I do that? Do I put two in the modifier?
Try it. Let's see if it works. So try two in the modifier first. I don't know. It may work. We'll see.
And which one is this?
So if you put two in the modifier, you're going to grab the damage. It's thug 3. Or you can drag it on the token. Lug 3 gains 6 wounds. Let me see what his soak is. Hang on. I think that's right. Yep, that worked. So, yeah, you can do that from now on. Add 2 to the modifier when you drag it over. Cool.
Excellent.
And then add your plus 30 to your Vibro X for the crit, if you're doing a crit.
Yes, I want to do a crit.
Uh-huh. All right. So you gave him a stinger.
Really? That
increases his difficulty by 1 for the next check.
And I think that is it.
All right.
Peshaw says, he doesn't hit like a Wookiee.
Stay hidden behind your table, little man.
My table's no longer there. It's flipped up.
All right, so Teemo the Thug 2 is going to go next. He looks in pretty rough shape. And he is going to take a shot. And he is going to shoot at, I think, he's going to shoot at Sari. And I will increase it correctly this time. Oh yeah, 2 threat. Thank you. Appreciate that. You're right.
Is that 2 strain?
Yep, 2 strain. Yep. Thank you for catching that. All right, sorry. He's going to take another couple blaster shots at you again here.
So I'm undercover this time.
Oh, you are undercover. Okay, great. So that's going to be 2 setback die. Oh. So, that's a critical fail for him, actually. I thought it was for you, but it's for him.
Did you upgrade the difficulty dice again?
Did I? I did! Arrgh!
So just drop that red one.
That's fair. That's frustrating. I'm re-rolling. Thank you for catching that. I appreciate that. So we'll just do the damage to you, actually. That'll be fine. And what do I use his advantage for? He'll give advantage to his next partner, his next friend. And so as an action or a maneuver, he actually dives down underneath the table and takes cover as well. All right, who wants to go next?
Go ahead, Pash.
All right, I'll go.
All right, Pash, so you're prone.
I am.
All right.
Is the Teemo Thug and Teemo Thug 1, are they even moving or awake or?
No, they're kind of incapacitated. They're not moving at all. They don't do, when you're incapacitated, you can't really do anything. You're kind of out of the fight.
Okay, good. Teemo Thug 3, he is in combat with.
Correct. He's engaged. Fuzzball. Yep, he is engaged. 2 is hiding behind a table, so he has cover, which would give you a setback back.
3 or you're
2 is 2 is in cover underneath the table, so that'd give right. you a setback by 3 is engaged with Sly, so that would add a difficulty die.
Okay, and what is a difficulty just?
Yep. So difficulty die has more chance for failure than a setback die does. So if you can think of it, the more faces, the more likely it's either going to succeed if it's for you, or it's going to fail against you. That's the best way to think of those.
So I'd say then shooting at Thug 2 would be better.
Correct.
Okay. Well, I am going to aim.
Alrighty.
As my maneuver, and yep. I am going to fire my blaster at Thug 2.
Okay, sounds good.
And I'm going to try to do it where I'm going to take a ricochet blaster shot from the top so I can shoot, you know, ricochet it straight down on him.
I got you. I understand what you're doing. All right. So it's going to be your, for your dice pool, you're going to put in your weapons dice. They're in short range, so it's going to be an easy, which is 1 difficulty die.
Okay. And it's dark, right? So it'd be 2 difficulty dies?
Nope, that's going to be 2 setback dice because he's undercover and it's dark.
Okay, that sucks.
Nope, just left click on that die and it'll disappear in your box. Just left click.
Well, that was a difficulty die though. I put in there, wasn't it?
I don't think so. Is it? That's a weird symbol to me.
Yeah, I've not seen that one before.
So that's all right. Go ahead and drag your dice in there again. And then the difficulty is the purple die. Yep. And then 2 setback for it being dark and cover, and then you get 1 boost die for aiming. Did I miss anything? think that's it. Anybody else have anything else?
Calling it now, headshot.
You know what? I think I'm going to shoot. I want to use one of the light side tokens,
sure,
too.
Sure, absolutely. So you're going to go ahead and double click on the light side token or drag it in. How do you guys do that? I forget.
I drag one in, okay, and gotcha, drop it in the chat.
There you go. And then you're going to click the green plus. That'll increase your ability die to a proficiency die. Yeah, this is going to be. All right.
This is going to be what?
You're going to destroy this dude. Oh my god.
That's a Megan roll.
That is a Megan roll, man.
So much advantage.
Alright, well, you missed the shot, unfortunately.
Oh, you know what it was? Posh, you forgot to figure in that table has a wobbly leg on it.
My name ain't Posh there, Wiki Boy. All right, so I did not figure in that table. And so when I hit it with a blaster, it brought your table in such a way that the shot deflected away, but I don't know what I could do with that advantage.
Oh, my God, you got so much advantage there.
Well, what can I do with advantage?
Maybe you hit the table in such a way that it spun it out of the way.
Yeah, that's what I did.
All right,
it
sounds good.
I hit the table, and it flipped out of the way, so he's no longer undercover.
I like it. So we'll use that for three of them, and you have five left.
All right. Well, yeah, I can't like give anybody a boost die with them or anything
you
like
can.
That, right?
Yep, you can. So you can use two of them to give a boost die to a certain person.
Or I will give a boost die to Kip.
All right. So that leaves three left, and you could use it to give a boost die to somebody else, or you could recover strain, or you could get an extra maneuver.
And you can use more than one to recover strain at the same turn if you want.
I see that.
And you know what? I will use a maneuver to get cover.
Okay. All right. Gotcha.
And that would be it, right?
So you actually have a maneuver. Oh, you aimed. That's right. So yes, that would give you two. So you'd have one left, so you could recover one strain if you wanted. Or all right. Does that work?
Yeah, I guess so. I can't do a boost die, so I'll recover one strain.
All right, sounds good. So you took cover, you gave a boost die to Kip, and you destroyed his cover. Okay, yep, that sounds perfect.
Yep,
I like it. All right, thug number three. So,
it's like I meant to do that.
Is that what you tell Sari? All right.
I nod.
So he is going to have to try to shoot at you, I hate to say, because all his other attacks suck. So, Sly, he's going to try to shoot you with his holdout blaster. So I need help moving through this, because this is always a little challenging me. So it's easy for shooting, correct? No, it's all two. It's average, right? Because he's engaged.
I'll pull up that thing and see if that helps.
He's engaged, plus he gets an extra because it's a light weapon. So it's three difficulty.
It's dark.
Dark, so that's a difficulty die. And it looks like you'll get a boost die for the next attack against him.
So engaged is one difficulty if he's... With a ranged light, it's another difficulty.
All right, there you go. That's it. Okay. You're good with him taking a shot?
Yep, I don't have anything to affect it.
Well, he fails. So, as he takes the shot... Yeah, so
this is vibro axe.
Yeah, right. So as he takes the shot, he misses wide, so it goes wide throughout the bar.
I'm sorry, I forgot my armor added one more setback on that.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So it didn't do anything. So his shot goes wide, but he upgrades the difficulty of your next check.
Okay.
Alrighty. Alright. Players.
I think that'd be me.
Alrighty.
So I'm gonna use a maneuver and take an aim.
Okay.
Alright, so I'm gonna take an aim. And I've got a boost.
Yep.
And it's easy.
That's correct. Yep, short range.
And I don't have any setbacks.
Right, because of the lights, right?
And Thug 2 is up, right?
Thug 2 is up, and he's lost his cover. That's correct. Nice.
I hit something.
And got a crit.
No, I didn't.
No, she missed it by one.
Oh, I keep reading that wrong, yeah.
Yeah. So, as you hit him, you see he goes down and collapses down onto the ground. Go ahead and you can give his critical to him.
Almost picked up the vehicle.
Aww. So, you minor nick him, which does add a damage to him. And then, how would you like to use your two advantage?
I'm going to get rid of some of my strain.
Okay. All right, the Wookiee uses an action, runs over to here, and he's gonna hit the thug that's on the ground that you just shot.
Get him, buddy!
Oh, I need to steal somebody's fists. Fists on him. Sorry, bear with me. One sec. All right, there we go. Skip. All right, so he has that. Well, he would have engaged, so he would have taken two strain, but that's okay. So two difficulty die, he gets a setback die. I think that's it, right? In his drunken stupor, he takes a swing and misses the guy that's unconscious on the ground. But that gives the next person inspiration on whoever's going to be attacking next. So you get a boost die. And yeah, I think that'll be good. All right, next up.
I think, Sly, you should probably take it.
Okay, I'll take it. Okay, and it's normally two difficulty dice, but his action last turn, his special causes me to upgrade that, right?
That's correct.
I get a boost die from the Wookiee.
Yep. You get a boost die from him trying to shoot at you while he was engaged.
How does he get a boost die from the Wookiee if the Wookiee's on two? I'm just asking.
Yeah, yeah. So the Wookiee he had advantage, and since he's working with you guys, even though he's red, I can't change it. He decided to use his advantage to give the next person a boost die.
Oh, okay.
Yep, so he distracted him. So he's the guy was laughing at the Wookiee because he missed his buddy.
Is that it?
I think so, unless you have anything to add.
Nope, I don't think I'll spend any of the dice.
I don't think I will either.
Oh my god.
My goodness.
Oh, it's tight quarters back here, man. I'm swinging the axe and he keeps dodging and I hit the bar.
How would you like to use your advantage?
I will just use that to... Actually, you know what? I'll use it to give a boost to the next person going.
Okay, sounds good.
And, I don't want to get out of melee with him, so I'm fine where I'm at.
Okay, sounds good. Alright, who's going next?
I'd like to, if y'all are alright with it.
Yeah, sure. Go for it.
Alright, well... Now we got a decision to make. Teemo Mug 2, he's no longer undercover, so...
He's incapacitated, so...
Oh, 2 is?
Yep, the only one that's...
The one with the Wookiee?
Yep, the only one that's not is number 3, who's engaged with Sly.
Oh, so I don't even need to deal with that one, so...
Nope.
Ah, well, I guess do I have line of sight to be able to take a shot at Teemo Mug 3?
Probably would have to move. It looks like he definitely don't have line of sight.
So I could do, like they said, a small maneuver, so, or a small movement. I could roll out from under the table or roll over?
You can, and so the way, we don't really measure here, but it's, you can move up to a short range band, and the whole cantina is essentially short range band, so you could move anywhere within the cantina.
Well, what would be considered on the thing, it's like a incidental would be like a minor movement.
Oh, that would be like if you kind of, you know, moved your head to the side or you reached over and grabbed something like within your distance. It wouldn't, a full maneuver would be, if you wanted to do anything like where you stepped or moved anywhere more than, you know, 2 or 3 feet, it would definitely be a regular maneuver.
All right, well, so if I do an additional maneuver, it's added strain, right?
Yep, 2 strain.
Yep, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get up here, and I'm going to lay my pistol the rest on the edge there, take aim.
Okay.
So that's 2 strain.
Yep.
And I am going to take a shot at Teemo Thug 3.
Okay, sounds good.
I know shooting the melee, I might hit somebody.
You might. So I did it wrong for Sari earlier. I apologize, Sari. So the way it works is it's going to be your damage, your dice pool, and then it's going to be easy difficulty because it's short range. But you have to upgrade that because you're shooting into engaged. I actually did it wrong for Sari. Sorry about that.
So how do I upgrade it?
So you're going to click the plus purple.
I just drop it in there and click the plus purple?
Yep, exactly.
Okay.
And then it's dark. So you're going to take a disadvantage or a setback die.
One or two?
Just one. And then you get a boost for aiming. And you get a boost for from slide. And I'm going to increase the difficulty with a dark side point. So you're going to click the plus purple again. And that should adds another difficulty die.
Aw, you suck.
I know, right?
Maybe I'll do a light side point to counteract that.
You sure can if you want to.
Out of the corner of my eye, I see him aiming over the top, so I'm kind of just shifting my position a little bit so that the guy's back is more to
me. I really don't want to shoot him, so you know what? I'm going to do that.
All right, so you're going to up increase it? All right, sounds good. So you're going to click the... you're going to double-click on that boost die for me, the one that you added. Go ahead
double
and get rid of that.
Left-click?
Yep. And then you're actually going to increase your ability, so you're going to change a green to a yellow. So you're going to click the green plus. There you go. That'll give you chances for more triumphs, so the specials.
All right.
All right, whenever you're ready.
Woohoo!
Nice job.
So I drag a damage onto him?
Yep, you do. And so that knocks him out. So you can drag a personal critical onto him because he takes that from maximizing his damage. All right, so he's distracted, which really doesn't make a difference at this time. But and then you can, for your triumph, you can use it kind of however you want.
Oh, for the special?
Yep. You could do a critical. You could do something extraordinary. You could upgrade some people's checks if you wanted to.
I don't think we. This basically ends combat, right?
Pretty much does. Yeah.
But if just out of curiosity, Greg, if he upgraded dice, those would save over for the next rolls that he would do
Correct.
For skill checks or something?
Correct. For the very next skill check, it would upgrade it. Or upgrade the difficulty for the posers.
I'll upgrade the next skill check, I
guess. All right. Sounds good. All right. Sounds great. So you guys have 4 people knocked out. You see everybody at the bar is kind of like cowering and hiding. Several people have sort of run out. The Rodian's gone and the Twi'lek is gone. They've kind of split.
Right as he collapses, I'm going to say, I can't believe these guys actually attacked us in here for no reason. Hopefully the bartender hears it.
All right, gotcha. Yeah, the bartender's kind of like cowering behind the bar and he sort of stands up and he says, "Oh my god, who's going to pay for that?"
They were here for the Wookiee.
The Wookiee looks at you and he's like, he's like,
you better run.
All right, why don't you go ahead and give me a persuasion or deception? I don't care, whatever you want to do. I don't think it's persuasion.
I use perception.
Yeah, it's not perception.
I mean, sorry, not perception.
Not skullduggery?
It'd be deception, maybe?
Yeah, I think it's probably deception, is probably what it is.
Can she do an upgrade, or is it just me that could do an upgrade?
You can give it to her if you want.
I give it to her.
All right, gotcha. So go ahead and upgrade your deception. And the Wookiee is, what did we say? Was he one last time? I got to look and see.
It was one last time.
Okay, yeah, so one, yep. So he literally like drops everything he has and literally like runs out of the bar, and you see there's like 35 credits laying on the ground.
I'll scoop it up and I'll go kneel down next to this guy like I'm trying to help him, and I'll pat his pockets down. I want to grab his data pad or anything to it so that I can get their identities.
Sure, absolutely. So you grab what looks like a data pad that's there for him as well.
Does that first guy still have his data pad?
You're more than welcome to search him if you'd like.
Yeah, because he was flipping through it when I was sitting there.
So as you kind of go through and search his pockets, he does not have a data pad.
I already have that one. I'm leaving. Bad people are probably on the way.
I'm gonna look.
What about this guy here?
Look at if they had any credits on them or grab their weapons too.
All right, gotcha. So there's 93 credits on that one, Sly. They have holdout blasters. That's what they have. There's 13 credits on the one that you just searched, Pash.
What about the other thug that the leg came off of?
Yep. And that one has 18 credits.
Does he have a data pad?
Nope. There's only two of the four have data pads.
Okay.
But there is holdout blasters, so... you can grab whoever wants those holdout blasters. You can grab those and drag them into your inventory.
I'm standing out here just checking just watching to see if, you know, any authorities or anything comes.
Gotcha. Alrighty. Okay. I'll have you go ahead and give me a perception check with average difficulty, just because there's a lot of people there and you've been there for a week, but you don't really know who the authorities are. Cool.
I need to grab the holdout blaster.
Okay, gotcha. So on your inventory tab, just so you know, Brian, for for encumbrance. So if you are not actually holding something as a weapon, it actually adds to your encumbrance. So if you look at your inventory tab, you see it there?
I'm on it.
Okay, gotcha. I think, can you grab the little symbol for the holdout blaster and put it in your sheet? I can't remember if you guys can do that or not.
Where's the symbol for the holdout blaster?
It's a little, it looks like a rebel symbol. It's on the chat window. I dragged it in there. Can you guys do that or no? I don't remember.
I just did it.
Yep. And so since you're not actually, are you going to wield that or are you going to keep your blaster pistol?
I'm keeping my blaster pistol.
All right, so you're going to unclick the combat box. And you're going to click, yep, there you go. And so it adds one to your encumbrance. So you can hold a maximum of 8, and your encumbrance currently is 1.
All right, and my vibro knife should be not in my combat thing either, should it?
So the vibro knife is okay.
Okay.
But the blaster pistol is okay, but not the holdout blaster. So if you want to grab four of them, you could all four of them and carry them. You could put a 4 in the quantity, and that would increase your encumbrance to 4, which you definitely could carry.
Hey, Greg.
Yeah.
When I click on the combat box, all that does is add or remove it on my combat tab. It's not changing my encumbrance at all.
Correct. You have to click the weight sign on the right.
Any left? Holdout blasters left?
There's 4 of them, unless somebody else takes them. So.
See where 2 people grabbed them.
Okay.
So if you want me to, I'll grab that last one.
I picked up one.
Mess with, Sorry, go ahead.
I picked up one off of the guy that was in the booth.
Okay, then we're all done.
Alrighty, sounds good. So next thing we need to do is we need to recover some strain. So after every combat, you have the ability to recover strain. I believe it's either discipline or cool. Do you guys, does anybody remember if that's accurate?
Either one.
Either one. So you put either your cool or your discipline in the combat, whichever one you want. So if you want to put one in and see what it's like and then cancel it out, you can and put the other one in. And then you roll it. Every success you get reduces your strain. Advantage does nothing. Gip, nice work.
So three green dice or one yellow dice?
I'd go with three green.
All right, Sly, you didn't get anything. Posh, you recover four strain. Nice job.
So my name's not Posh. It's Posh.
I can't help it. All right.
It's your accent.
It's your accent. I just got that.
Definitely not Corellian, but that does.
Sly and Kip, as you're out there, you're kind of looking around. You don't see anybody that looks like they are paying any to the wiser at this point, at least. That being said, the people that were in the bar are clearly running down the street and sort of yelling as they go.
Right, I guess
this isn't like the bar where Obi-Wan cut the guy's hand off. They just all started to turn around and started drinking again.
Yeah, no, it kind of wasn't.
We're in a civilized part of the universe. Captain, sorry, we should probably get out of here before too many people notice us.
I notice people notice you.
I'm going to climb in the driver's seat of our vehicle. I'm assuming we brought it when we came out into town.
I'm sure you did. Your land speeder?
Yes. I look at Sly and I'm like, move our fuzzball. Let a pro get up here and drive.
That's actually his name is Fuzzball.
Where were we supposed to meet Gosler?
Who?
I haven't told you yet.
Yeah.
At a warehouse.
Well, didn't I get the rest of the information? Should have an address or something.
It was in the Black District. I don't think they gave you an address.
It was 123 wrong way.
So you just said a warehouse in the Black District. Yep. Hopefully there's only one. We're heading to the Black District. Do you know where that is, new guy?
You navigate me and I'll drive there.
Yeah, it's south.
I don't know where it is.
I was talking to the new guy.
But only if I get to drive. I'll take you there. That's what you got me. That's what you brought me on for, is a drive. I'm your galactic Uber.
Uber Pash.
Fine, I'll get in the back seat.
So I'm going to relay all the information to Kip that we're going to meet this Kaya Gosler. He's got a bounty for us on planet here for somebody named Bryn who works at at space control.
All right.
And when we get there, I'm going to count on you to do the negotiating.
Negotiating? What's the price?
Don't know yet.
Okay.
Just said... Dad said it'd be a lot.
So, I don't know if I know exactly, so I'm going to throw a streetwise in there and see if I can figure out where this black whatever it is.
That sounds good. So, I'm going to have you do an average difficulty, so that's two difficulty die. And I'll let you have a boost die because you've been in the city for a bit now.
Hey, I can help him. Because we've been here a week, you know, maybe I can remember something. I am trained in it, so.
All right, so what's your streetwise?
that.
All right. So the way this works, Brian, is you look at the two streetwise and you see if there's anything that you can take from hers to increase yours. So if you both have, I forget, does she, your skill automatically applies though, right?
Because
right.
Go ahead, Russell.
I was going to say, if she doesn't have anything better than he does, it just adds a boost die to it.
What if she's proficient, though? I thought her skill adds, no?
Yeah, I think if it's proficient, he would, like...
Because you're right. Normally, it would be the boost die, but I don't know if she's if she has a skill in it, if that increases.
Well, how do I put my... I don't have a name in the dice pool tracker.
For your streetwise?
My name isn't in the dice pool tracker.
Yeah, we never see ourselves.
Thank you. Okay. Yep, you can only see everybody else. That, I think that's because you can see your own box, so that's why. I'm looking
at page 25, assisted checks. If you're skilled, your dice pool can use one character's characteristic and the other's skill rating. If you're unskilled, if a characteristic or skill is not higher than the person being assisted, add a boost to check.
So I'm a yellow and two little greenies.
Which is the same as Kip.
So you just get a boost, I said.
Yep, just a boost. But that's all right. Boost is a boost. Alrighty. Thank you. I appreciate that, Russell.
I know I'm annoying, but...
No, it's okay. I'd rather know the rules correctly. So, all right. So, Posh, you know where it's at.
Yeah, and I got two advantages out of that. So not only do I know where it's at, I know the secret way in.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah, I know the way how to get in there. You know, the passcode or the secret way in.
Gotcha. So you see, he quickly kind of Posh you. You start on your direction, right?
Yep. My name's not Posh. It's Pat.
You will forever be. Never mind. All right. So you continue to drive through the streets. As he does, you all have been here for about a week now, so you are familiar with the area here. However, he drives it back into sort of the a little bit of a different district necessarily. And you guys see there's this warehouse that's there, and you see he drives right past the front door. And you see on the it says, you know, it says Gosler's warehouse supplies. He drives right on by.
Stop.
Where are you going, buddy?
I know a different way in.
Into the warehouse.
Yeah. Well, never go through the front door. People are watching.
Yeah, okay. But, okay.
And I take him around to around back to, you know, a different door that's like an alley over. And I'm like, okay, right here.
Yep.
We'll go through here.
As you get out, you see that there is a door there, and it looks like a delivery door, and it has a code pad that's next to it, and the door is closed.
I go up there and punch the key access code in.
Alrighty. So you kind of start to punch in the code. Yeah. So Sly grabs the keys as you get out. What's the rest of people doing as he runs up to the door to punch in the key code?
I'm kind of nervous about going in the back door because sometimes people take offense to that, but I'll just get ready in case something bad happens. Oops, we lost somebody.
We did. Oh, we lost Bailey.
Megan got mad because she couldn't play, so she disconnected Bailey's voice.
Yeah. She completely disconnected her. She's completely out. Hopefully she comes back. All right, so, okay. Hash, as you go up there, I need a computer's check.
Computer's check, huh?
Yeah, you got this.
I don't have a computer. Oh, yeah, I do have computers.
You do. Even if you're untrained in it, you can still do it.
All right, there's my computers.
Punch the buttons! That's my assistant. Punch the buttons!
So you get a boost die from Sly. And it's going to be an average difficulty, so that's two difficulty die. All right.
Oh man. So my skull drudgery wouldn't come into this for like splicing or anything?
No, because you're trying to get into the access the computer.
All right. Hey, here we go.
Brian, if we don't screw things up, we're not playing this game right.
It's Star Wars. So you punch on that keyboard.
But I don't get in. It doesn't go yet.
Yeah, you hear a eh.
But I got...
You got advantage.
Three advantages.
You do.
So can I try again? Mm. And I'm going to use my advantage dies to give me a boost die?
You can. It does increase the difficulty each time you try a skill check that you failed. But you absolutely can try it again. Why not? What do you got to lose?
Yeah, why not?
Well, you could also give an advantage and let me try if you want.
I'm like, man, I tell him, okay, that's what I'll do. I'll give him a boost die. And I'm like, hey, the numbers are 5, 4, 3, 2, star, squiggly line, green, purple, 5.
So I'll have you kind of put that up. Sorry, as they're doing that, you see you see.
I'm just knocking the thing off the wall.
So you see a droid is kind of coming down. It's a large circular droid. It's got a round head, probably about four feet in diameter. It stands about 2 feet tall, and it sort of stops, and you see its head sort of looks towards you guys.
Just as I swing my axe.
Right.
I think I got it open.
So you hit the pad, and the pad literally strips off the wall. There's wires, sparks, and everything. The droid quickly turns his head and moves very quickly down the street.
So now we're breaking in. This is ultimately better than going in the front door.
It's broken, man. What are you doing? He broke it.
Sly.
He's destroying the evidence.
No. You provided
Can I
evidence.
Use those two advantages to remove a couple strain.
Yeah, that's fine.
And then I'm just going to push on the door.
Okay.
We couldn't have just gone in the front door.
I'll motion pass inside.
All right. So as you push on the door, you feel the door doesn't move.
Oh, sure. Now it's locked down.
Yeah, that's what goes through the front door.
We're going to get blasted for a meeting we're supposed to have, guys. Holy moly. I start walking to the front door.
Right. So you guys see Sari walks around the building as you're both standing at the door.
I'll hop at the speeder to take it around the front door, and I'm like, where's the keys?
I just look at him and shrug, and I start walking to slowly follow Sari around the front. I have my axe up on my shoulder.
I look around and I'm like, eh. I jump out and I go with them.
That's funny. All right, so the two of you guys go around to the front. Sorry, as you come around to the front, you see what appears to be an entrance door that's there. There's not a service entrance or anything like that. It looks like it opens up into the office.
Is there a receptionist or anything?
There's not. You kind of open up the door and look, and there's a small desk there. There's a bunch of what looks like filing cabinets or places they would keep kind of that archaic paper stuff that nobody uses anymore. You see there's like a little desk lamp that's there that's lit, and behind there you see a Tordarian that's kind of sitting there. His wings are sort of beating, and he's kind of writing quickly on a piece of paper, one of this archaic thing with a stick, and he's kind of writing. He looks up and he says, "What do you need?"
Looking for Kaya Gossler. Got an appointment.
He kind of looks up to you and he says, "I'm Kaya Gossler. What do you need shipped? You need something stored?"
"I'm here to do something for Mr. Gossler himself. He's requested my presence."
Kind of looks at you and he says, "Man, is that a blaster wound?"
"Yep."
"Damn, dude. Get in a fight?"
"Always."
He just likes to shoot himself as we're walking down the street.
And he sees the two of you walk in, and he's like, "This isn't a shakedown, is it?"
"Nah, they're with me, though."
"All right. Rondi didn't send you, did he?"
"No."
"Good, good, good, good. So, I don't ever remember asking for, two humans and a, what, kitty cat?
Yeah, it's kind of what he is. Taz, he sent me.
Oh, really? Tazzy who?
That's not fair.
I'm gonna drop my axe. I'm gonna drop the axe handle onto the floor and just rest my arm on top of the head of the axe.
Are you Kaya Gosler?
He's like, yeah.
Okay. Tazzy sent me. Said you had a bounty you wanted on some space control dude. If you want me to do it, I'll do it. If you're gonna be difficult, then I can just leave right now and I can find something else to do.
You see his wings start moving really quickly, and he looks around. He's like, "Hey, shh, keep it down."
Not allowed. Well, quit trying being difficult then.
I'm sorry. You're obviously serious men. I apologize.
Definitely.
I got a bounty. Yeah, Bryn, over at the spaceport.
Okay.
That bitch tied down my ship, and she won't let me let it out. So I need you to teach her a lesson.
Is this a permanent lesson or a temporary one?
Depends. How good are you?
I don't know. I'm pretty good. I'm the best.
Can you make it so it doesn't come back on me?
Sure. Why would it come back on you?
I don't know.
Have you made threats?
Maybe. Yeah?
Well, it's going to be difficult not to have it come back on you then, isn't it?
Well, I mean...
That makes the price go up.
What? I'm already paying 2,000 credits.
That's for just doing the basic. You want me to make it look like it wasn't you. Now that makes it harder, especially when you've... threaten the person.
All right, what's your price?
At least twice that.
Twice? This is highway robbery. He, unfortunately, Kip is predisposed, so you are negotiating, I guess.
Yep.
All righty. So, why don't you go ahead and put your negotiation dice in there.
Can I boost aid you him can. With my coercion since I'm wiping blood off the axe?
Yep, you absolutely can. Pash, do you have negotiation skills too?
Let me see. No, I don't have that skill.
All right. Do you mind just dragging it into the combat tracker? Because you maybe will give him, or into the dice pool, sorry. Okay. So as you can see, Sari has two negotiation and you have three. Right? Tell me if I'm wrong, Sly.
So yeah, I got three.
Yep, so he can take one of his green, right?
Hold on.
I believe so.
Yeah, I believe he can actually use his the extra green die from him.
That's what I thought. So even though you're not proficient in the skill, Pash, because of your characteristics, it gives you three dice. So you can actually boost or give Sari one of your green dice when he's negotiating.
Oh, so, wait a minute. He's unskilled?
He's unskilled.
In that case, yeah, if it's unskilled, if a characteristic or skill is not higher than the person being assisted, add a boost die.
Sorry.
And skilled, dice pool can use one character's characteristic and the other's skill rating.
Gotcha. Okay. All right, so you get a boost. And then coercion for the Tordarian. Let me just see what his stats are here. So, because we got to make sure that you can scare him, right? Opposed by his discipline.
Just trying to distract him and make him a little bit nervous in the negotiations with Captain Sari.
Yep, that's what I figured. So you're going to have three die, Sly. Three ability die, or difficulty die. That's a hard
one. Wow, these guys don't scare, eh?
No, they're Tardarians, so. Oops, not Sari. Sari, can you clear yours for me for a quick second? Oh, is negotiation under the same? No. Go ahead, Sly. Go ahead and roll yours. All right. So you try to intimidate him, but he doesn't seem too intimidated as you try.
But I can use those two advantages. One advantage to give the next roll a boost,
sure.
And one advantage to remove all the blood from my axe.
Sounds good.
And get rid of a strain.
All right. So, sorry, you can do your negotiation roll with your a boost die, two boost die, actually. And then he has a cool rating of 3, so it's going to be 3 difficulty die.
Can I possibly use my streetwise to help him boost it up?
Maybe.
This is kind of sounds like it's not really on the up and up.
Okay. All right. Gotcha. So, yep, you can. So, it would take away one of his boost die because we were using that for the negotiation. But if you want to, you can use streetwise. Sure. Absolutely. So go ahead and have you put in the streetwise for me, Pash.
Yeah, because I've got that one. Like, okay. I know who his boss and stuff is, and like.
Gotcha. Yep.
It's my streetwise.
All right. Gotcha. And then, so I'll have you do a. We'll do an average difficulty, so that's going to be 2. There you go.
This might not help.
It may or may not. We can try. Yeah, it does. So it ends up giving him a boost die anyways, but it works out fine. That's okay, though. That's all right. So you do. So you kind of say, you know, you kind of talk about his boss and stuff like that. All right, sorry. I think we're ready. Nice. So he
I'm standing there and I cross my arms across my chest and say, take it or leave it.
He's like,
I'm going to quietly, as very, very quietly, so maybe Sorry can only hear it then. Hopefully, I'm going to say, wow, those lessons from Kip really have been paying off, huh?
So he's like, okay, all right, fine. He's like, if you make it real messy and don't connect it to me, I'll throw in an extra 500 credits, all right? 4,500.
All righty.
All right, but you got to make it messy. Make an example.
I thought you said double. Sorry.
Well, it was 2,000, now it's 4,000, and then he's going to give us 500 if we make it real messy.
Okay.
Nice. Like, I like it. He's like, all right, so you have to go over to Spaceport Control. She's usually there at night.
All right.
Now that's the general spaceport. None of these little secretive spaceports that other companies and corporations use. Got it?
The general spaceport, yep.
Yeah, general spaceport.
I have a question.
Okay.
How is this going to get your ship unlocked?
I'm going to have a droid go in there and unlock it for me. Unless you guys specialize in that as well. I could throw in a little extra credits.
I look at him, I'm like, the little Wookiee guy there, he's not specializing in unlocking anything.
No? You're not good, huh?
He's just upset because I can solve a problem better than him.
Our slicer's on a side mission this week, so. Mm. Don't have our slicer with us. So.
Mm.
So, I don't think we can take that on.
Sorry, are we? How are we taking out this person? Are we taking them out, or are we taking them out?
This sounds like a all or nothing type of deal.
So I have a Star Wars question. This is a bounty hunter mission, correct?
Yep.
Is bounty hunting illegal or legal in the universe?
Kind of depends on where you're at.
Okay, then I'm going to look over at Sari and say, is this a legal or an illegal thing that we're about to do? Since you're getting a bounty on this.
I take the bounties and execute them. the illegality of it, I don't really think about.
I'm not talking morally. I'm talking about, are we going to have cops chasing us down? Sorry, are we going to have the Imperial troopers chasing us because of this, or the local cops?
I kind of doubt it. I don't know. Is this an Imperial employee?
He goes, are you taking the job or not?
Answer his question.
He's like, well, she may have ties to the Imperials. I mean, it's the main spaceport. You know, they have to tax and stuff. You gotta watch out for the BOSS. I mean, they're trouble, right?
Yeah.
Anyways, you'll be fine. I mean, nobody's gonna know. You're gonna make it messy, right?
We'll make it messy.
We'll make it look like a rebel.
We'll make a plan.
Oh, good idea. Make it look like the rebels. I like that.
Do you have her home address?
What? You think I'm dating her?
You got a picture?
Like, no, I don't have a. I'm not. We're not lovers, okay?
Well, how am I supposed to know which one Bryn is?
You'll know. She runs the place. Can't miss her. She looks very studious.
I think since we're taking this big chance here, we get half up front and half when the job's done.
What kind of bounty hunters are you all? How do I know? Well, then I keep your speeder. Give me the keys.
I look at Sari and just slightly shake my head no.
He's like, I saw you guys in the back trying to get in. Don't worry, I got security cameras. You guys see like this really archaic sort of CCTV sort of screen there, and you can see your speeder bike back there, or your land speeder.
Yeah, we'll take the bounty. We'll figure out how to do it in transit somehow.
I'm sure we won't have any problem getting paid for doing it.
Of course not. Alright.
And we are on a Black Sun planet after all.
True. He puts his little hand out, he says, shake on it.
And sure. You see Pat start gyrating, shaking around.
He's like, hey, your buddy's having a seizure over there.
Yeah, he's new. I don't know what he's like. I really don't know him yet.
Oh my gosh, you guys, you're that new of a crew? Man, I'm being charged way too much. If anybody comes asking, any Imperials or anything, I know nothing. And that speeder bike's parked back there illegally.
Yeah, well we're moving there long.
Who's nothing?
Huh?
You said you don't know nothing. Who is nothing? I have never heard of nothing.
Sorry?
What?
Huh? What? Why'd you say what?
I'm turning you said sorry. Back out.
I did. I said sorry because I didn't know what he was saying.
And I said what?
Huh? Like, this is the worst decision ever. He goes back to working on his paperwork.
I want it in writing, pal.
You want what in writing?
The amount.
You hear him grumble and he writes, you see, he takes a piece of paper and he writes 4,500 credits and hands it to you. He's like, there, it's writing.
Okay. Is this sanctioned by the Bounty Hunters Guild?
He's like, why is that guy asking so many questions? Are you new at bounty hunting?
Because he knows the Star Wars universe more than we do.
He's like, no. Wait a minute.
Taz set this all up, so it's on the up and up.
You guys are serious business, aren't you?
Yeah, we're serious. So let's go get in the speeder. We'll plan this out.
All right, sounds good.
We'll have to stake out the spaceport and get a feel for who this Bryn is and what their routine is.
Okay, sounds great.
I'm driving back this time.
Have you heard anything from Bailey?
I haven't.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
sure. No, I logged into or went visible on my Steam account and she's not shown as being on at all, so.
Yeah, she must have lost everything, I guess.
Okay, hopefully she's all right. I'm sure she is. So, alrighty. So you guys kind of walk out. As you do, you see the sun is starting to set, putting sort of this greenish light glow across that you recognize. Their sunsets are more of a green, not a red sort of sunset. The shadows are sort of cast between the buildings.
We, where did we go? Head over to the general spaceport?
You can, yeah. Is that where you guys are headed?
Yeah, we'll head over there and park outside across the street and down a bit from the employee entrance.
All right, so you guys kind of hop in and start heading that way. As you do, you continue kind of traveling down the passages and roads and things like that.